mighty race fans. This is not an optimal day for the last race of the season. MSSA Fall Jackrabbit race number 6. Last race of the season, 2018. It's been raining like hell. Might clear, who knows? It's 26 after, and we're gonna set off of our little mooring ball here because we're crazy. But hey, half of sailing and racing is showing up, so we're gonna show up as long as the transmission works and the engine's going. Okay, everything feels great. Alrighty, so here we go. So to give you a little taste of what we're up to, there's Eric's boat over there. He's been helping raise and nest a lot of cormorants out there. Sorry, Eric. And here we go, babies. A little bit more video to follow, but at the moment, we're just setting off. Here we go. Hang on, folks. It might clear, so we'll see what happens. That's what they always say. These are the same guys that tell you you're getting a snowstorm and nothing happens, or you know the drill. Alrighty, we're off. Talk to you later. Here we are. Ooh. Fall 6, last race of the season. Things got a little ugly there. We got a couple puffs over 17. Crew didn't like it, so we decided to do, supposed to be called a jiffy reef. And you can see, if you're looking up here, it ain't pretty. A couple other boats started behind me. They're kind of catching up. Obviously, it probably cost me about 5-10 minutes back there putting this jiffy reef up here. Pretty ugly. But I can't handle that kind of puff on the main. It's very tough to control by myself. I want to drop the traveler down. I mean, there's all kinds of stuff I'm going to want to do if we get caught in a puff. So we're sitting in 13 plus true, 13, 14 at the moment. You can see it's raining. Pretty good rain. Not the most horrible rain, but it's wet. I mean, we're soaked. But that's what we're up to. Sailing along, just trying to maintain our course there, keep the telltale happy. Whoa, whoop, there's a puff, there's a puff. Whoa, the hell was that thing? And heading out for Mark C. And then all we do is come back. Thank goodness, this is the type of day that should be short and sweet. Just get this thing in. You know, if I can stay up with these guys with all their sails out, they got crew, they can handle a puff or a shot. I am gonna try and get up and trim up the main a little bit. That is OCD, very annoying for me. So, here's what we're up to. We can't point as high either. So our goal is gonna be to stay up here as much as we can on this mark. And try not to have to tack over too badly. But as you can hear, we got the awning up. That's not sailing approved either for racing. Little windage there, but it's keeping us nice and dry. All right, that's enough for this right now. We'll talk to you later. Realizing this may be the last duel between those two. Uh-oh. All right, guys, there we go. There they are. Battling it out. Anomaly and the muffin, ragamuffin. Go, buddies. Unfortunately, as you can see, I'm hanging on here. I can't even tell who the hell's in first at the moment. It'll probably change. This one's for you, John. Last race for the muffin and anomaly. Up at the moment, but we can't drop it. Alright, we're gonna kind of ride this out for a few minutes, see what the hell happens. Look at this surf that's kicked up. Sorry for the language. It's just one of those kind of situations. Are you kidding me? Around the spinnaker? God damn it. My crew sucks. At some point during all that fun. We're actually gonna have to tack here. We gotta go out that way where those boats are. Man, she's not happy. Alright, we may choke in a little more of the jib because we don't need all that up there. Here we go. We're gonna let her out a little. Pull her in a little more. It's almost like a storm jib. There it is. All right. Now we're gonna do a little tackeroni. This isn't gonna be pretty, but maybe effective. No, maybe we're not gonna freaking tack. Here, we'll let it backwind it a little, and then we're gonna tack. Okay, you ready? Wow, this is not nice stuff. All right, here we go. We're coming about. Ready? Here we go. Come on. No big waves. Like I said, no big waves. Of course, what do we get hit by? Freaking big wave. God damn it. All right. Pushed us back. All we want to do is tack without a big freaking wave stopping us from tacking. One more time. Well, probably more than one. All right, let's go. Ready? Here we go. Just gotta time it so we don't get hit by the one rogue wave that stops us from going past 12 o'clock. Come on, buddy! Nope. Didn't damn make it. Shit! Look at these things. Oh, my goodness. Up a little speed. Look for lower waves. We'll go after the wave hits us. The second one here. Ready? Here we go. Here we go. Come on, mama. There you go. A little flat spot. Come on, give me a break, mama. There you go. There you go. freaking ugly. All right. Good time here, and it's not getting better. It seems like it's getting worse. 22 sustained, got a 27 plus hits. True. Wow. All right, let's see what we do. 60 degrees to the wind. Well, look at these rollers here, baby. These are all wind created. Of course, the tide's coming in because it was low when we headed out, and the tide's coming this way. All right, well, we'll just keep an eye on it. 21, at least we go down below 20, sustained. All right, I gotta shut this off. My head's getting really wet. Sustained. 28 was some of the peak true. What's somewhat impressive, if you want to call it that, is the sea state has really kicked up here. It never really comes up looking that good on cameras. I don't know if it's a depth perception or what's going on, but you can take my word for it. Is some fairly impressive wave heights that have whipped up here. You can see the clouds kind of moving out, kind of this thick band. But here's what's kind of impressive here are these little dudes. This boat weighs 6 tons, actually a little more than that. And we are bobbing around out here like a freaking rubber ducky in a bathtub. So, I don't know who that is up there. I think that might be Roadrunner, or it might be That's Ridiculous has made the mark, and they're going back down. So, I'm either determined enough or stupid enough. I want to stick it. Oh, wait, the wind's dying a little bit. Ooh, 13, 14. Now, that's a tease. So, anyway, we got to get out to that mark out there. You can't tell. It's the red-white center buoy marker. C. And these boats are all trying to get there. So are we, so are they. That one's going downwind. So we're gonna keep at it. Look at this guy breaking. Actually, we're gonna go into that thing. All right, let's hang on for that. I mean, you can see this is a pretty impressive little wave unit here. Ooh, and of course now the wind picks up right as we're going through the stupid thing. All righty, woo! Come on, baby. you down. Maybe we'll be watching this from the warmth of a fireplace or something. Look at those boys breaking. Those are not small rollers. Actually, this whole front that we're coming up on is not small. All right, let's, hold on. I'm gonna hold on to the wheel here. I can't put you down yet. All right, let's see here. We're going to, and we're going down, and we're going up, and we're going down. That wasn't too bad. Kind of dissipated, thank goodness. All right, onward to Mark C, down there. Man, it looks like it's far. We're only making 1.8 knot towards the mark because we're kind of crabbing off to the left here. You can see there it is, and we're kind of going sideways to it. We may have to tack again. Every time we tack this way, the wind clocks around to the northwest, and we end up going that way. And then it shifts back, and then we go this way, and it goes that way. I think they call that sailing. All right, let's hang on for one more couple rollers here. Woo. And here we go up, and here we go down. Here we go up, here we go down. Here we go. Up and down, up and down, up and down. It's going up and down. Thank goodness I don't have labyrinthitis back again. That would be not a good thing to have right now. Okay. Apologies for all the cursing in the previous video. My crew was a little disheveled there, and we were having, of course, every possible hang-up on the boat. All right. All right, we may have to tack here soon. Because we're not making much headway. Kicked us in the butt. Alright, so maybe we'll be tacking. Yeah, it looks like we can tack and go there. Alright, that's what we're doing. Hey, you want to hang out for that?
Sure! Alright!
I can hear you clapping. I hope it doesn't catch anything bad. Alright, here we go. We're going to try and tack her. Let's not lose our $150 winch handle. Travel down, get her set up. All right, two wraps on this boy. Having fun on a cooler. All right, here we go. Jibe ho! Uncle Todd, this one's for you, baby. Protect me. Come on, come around, come around, come around. These waves make it tough to tack. Such a little amount of jib area. There she is. We may have to squeak a little more jib out.
Woo, come on, come on, baby!
Alright, there she is. Get back up, like 26 degrees. What the hell's going on with that? Alright, back up to the north we go. That wasn't textbook, but we're still talking about it. Woo. All right, we're kind of on a little bit of a better sea state angle from this way. Oh. Okay, yeah, we're about 52 degrees to the wind. I'm not loving this, but they're gonna go over there. God, we're only making two knots to the mark.
Sheesh!
Alright. I think we're gonna stay on this one for a couple minutes, maybe. This is a little bit of a bummer of an angle because the wind's coming right up off the port side. We're heading into it at a pretty aggressive angle. But the wind's taking us that way. And all that really means is every once in a while, conditions are good for us to feel like a Volvo 70 boat. That's right. Here we go. I don't think you're going to see any right away. Well, maybe you will. Hold on. Should we hang on for a couple more seconds? There's a couple breaking out there. All right. So we're about 57 to the wind. Wind's kind of, I can't believe I say this, died down to 17. And, see the birds up ahead, all kinds of fish coming up to the top, wondering what the hell's going on up there. All right, whoa, ho, ho. We got a couple up to the cabin, companionway. So I got the slide back. All right, I gotta put you down here. It's gonna be a few more minutes till we get there. It says 7 minutes, but come on. I know it's gonna be longer than that. Whoa! All righty. Hold on, we're putting you down. Couldn't help it. Look at this following sea. Oh my. There's Windborne. Hey buddies! We made it! Look at this following sea, man. Alright. Oh my god. Wow. That was epic. Not necessarily fun either. Alright. So, we're doing a strange wing on winger. We're in 17. I think we'll be dumb enough to choke out a little more jib just so we can get some downwind action here. Got the cars all the way up. Wow. Oh my. That was exciting. For all the wrong reasons, almost. All right, maybe a little more jib. Oh, God, I can't believe I'm going to do this. But we are. We can't let Jude beat us. Sorry, Jude. Just can't let it happen. All right, here we go. We got to get ourselves into the wind. Downwind directly so we can get this Genoa working for us. There she is. All right, see her, she's up. All right, what are we doing here? We're doing 4.5, 5. Look, we're not hitting that C. That's all that matters. All right, we're on our way home. Whoa, a little puffy. A little bit of rollers coming at us. All right, you're off.
I think we're recording. So, here's when you're in a 6-ton boat in 20 plus knots of true wind every once in a while. We're only 18 right now. But you've got this kind of following sea. Oops, sorry. And she's down to 13. Of course, when I turn the camera on. Oh, here comes a little puff. So anyway, a couple seconds ago, I think we were planing. We're doing 7 now, 6, 7, 7. Here we go, we're back up to 20 true. see if we can catch a wave, and we're sitting on top of the world. Isn't that a song? There she is. Woo! So the waves are just going a little faster than we are. 21, 22 sustained. Oh boy. You have to pay attention. See, you can see the white caps up ahead. So we're going east. That's the North Fork up ahead underneath the sail. Wine country. And the tide was low, so it's coming high, which means it's coming right at us. And the wind is blowing this way at 19 to, we peaked at 28 a little while ago. That was not fun. And so it causes this nice wave action. I really can't see it. You know, it's kind of a bummer. I guess you really got to appreciate it. But you can feel the boat honking around. And so you can see us, we just can't stay up with the waves. And so we kind of sit down on top of them and fall back. Kind of like a big surfboard. Alrighty. Was this enough fun for you? It's quite enough. Whoa, 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 whoa. Alrighty. Whoa! Come on, walrus. I am the walrus. Coo, coo, ka-choo. There it is. Alright. Anybody that sails knows how much fun this is. There's windboard over there, buddies. How's it going, buddy? See the front kind of coming through here. Oh man, okay. Well, we got 1 mile to the Dragon Lady. That's the temporary mark because our A mark snapped off and went to shore. So unfortunately, the A mark is where we start and where we finish. So luckily, Ragamuffin, on their final voyage and race, set the mark for us. And that's what's happening. Alrighty. See you soon.
Alrighty. We're dragging on down here to the Dragon Lady. In about 17 true. We flip-flopped the sails back here for a little wing-on-wing action. Downwind. Actually flicked you on because we're doing some really nice surfing there a few seconds ago. Wind was actually up around 20. And with that and the way we were set up, it was kind of a cool little thing here. But now it dropped down to 14, of course, the second we turned the camera on. And now we're just kind of falling behind the waves as they go. We're not staying up with them. But it's still not boring. Trying to stay dead downwind, kind of knocks us back and forth. Doing a little over six and a half at times, then we slow down as the wave goes under us to about 4.7 SOG, you know, speed over ground. And the water speed is really almost useless at this point, the way the water's shifting underneath the boat. There we are, a little surf action. Let's see, okay, we're picked up to about 17. Let's see if we can sync up with the wind behind us. Get ourselves up over 6. Okay, we're heading for the mark, which is all that really matters. Let's go down and get towards it. We just want to beat windborne, that's all. It kind of pulled ahead of us there as we were dorking around with the sails, playing with the other camera. My crew is so easily distracted, aren't you? Yeah. Okay. So there it is. Uh-oh. Backwind did the jab. Come on back, baby. There she is. Pop. That's great. That's right, Jim. I'm popping the sail. I'm more repairs for you this winter. All right. Let's get cracking here. You're distracting me. There's a little surfing. Whoa. Couple big waves. Woo, there we go, woo! Whoa. Oh, that's right, we're up to 20 again. Okay, hold on. You stay with me. Stay with me. Let's get a couple of these. See them back there? Whoa!
mama.
Come on, let's pop her back up for maximum downwind. Come on, come on. There she is. Go, baby, go. Let's catch this next wave. There she is. 19. All right, here we go. Here we go. This is what you do when you got nothing else to do. So try to beat somebody, like them. I'm hoping they're gonna have a little trouble getting back out here to the mark. Supposed to finish two boat lengths from it. Ooh, that was not pretty. All right, here we go. I think we need to get a little more clue action here. Let's get her down just a little bit so we flatten out the top. Just a little, nothing too dramatic. Keeps collapsing. The wind's just slightly off our starboard quarter, and this way we can keep her full a little better. You can see all the waves breaking up there. They're coming at us. You can see the rollers. All right. Well, I'm not sure how exciting this video is going to be, but I am having a lot of fun filming it. Uh-oh. Backwinded. Why? Why? You're not coming from there. Come on. There you go. Maybe because we were rolling down the wave. All right. We got to pretty much hang on this course right about here, right in towards Cedar Beach, to hit the hill and get to the Dragon Lady. The Dragon Lady! There she is. Can you see where she is? Yes. We're headed that way. Sort of. All right. Turning you off. Alrighty, well, we finished 12, 12:09:40, I think it was, and now we're going to go pick up the Dragon Lady in 20 knots of true wind. Damn, I think it got windier. All right, well, we're only making 2 knots here. Of course, we only have 15 horses. These rollers here, baby. These are not small. Oh my goodness. Come on. There we go. We gotta get some flat water under our butt so we can make some progress. There we are. 1-6, 2 knots. Okay, come on. Alrighty. Every half a minute or so, we end up getting some big chop. I don't know if you're still with me. Are you? I think you are. Oh boy. I didn't think this was going to be quite this difficult. Hopefully going to come at it from the east, since it's hopefully being blown this way and its scope and rope is out below it. I'm going to go up above it, put her in neutral and hopefully coast below it, and hopefully we don't get tangled up in the damn thing. All right. don't want the dragon lady to live up to her frickin' name. Alright. Here we come. Coming to the dragon lady. Only making two knots. Woo! Alright. Just flatten out enough for us to get near the damn thing, will ya? I just don't want to get tangled up in her. Uh-oh, here come a couple rollers. This isn't gonna be good. Come on. Of course, the biggest frickin' waves hit now. I'm either gonna snap it or I'm gonna get it. Come on. Come on! Fuck. Dragon Lady is aboard. I'm not doing that again.
Thank you, Tom.
God, are you still recording? Because that sucked.
I don't think you're recording. Just when you thought you had enough, we're in 23-25 through. Little 15 horse engines pull out. We're about 4 knots. Jack, I'm pretty happy with right now. We got the Dragon Lady. We almost didn't get the Dragon Lady. John, we almost didn't get it. That freaking anchor was holding good. Alrighty. We are done. I am not volunteering for that. I'm already in the calling next time. Alright, we're going in. And end of the Mount Sinai Sailing Association Fall Series.
Ever so humble, there's no place like home, especially your home harbor. Wow. Triple wow. Quadruple wow. Wow. Oh my. That was a heck of a last race. Doesn't even matter the time. Mine was, I think it was 12:09. 40 seconds, something like that. I don't know, it was after Windborne. And all that excitement, I may have actually screwed that time up. I didn't write it down. Like 12:09, it was after 12, after Windborne. I screwed it up, John, if you're even watching this. I'm sorry. But there's the Dragon Lady. She's in the boat. Got that thing. That is the hardest frickin' 7-pound anchor I've ever pulled up. In 20 knots of wind, and the two knot current. I didn't think I was gonna get it. I thought I was gonna cut it, or it was gonna snap. All right, we're back. We're here. Town of Brookhaven, Mount Sinai Harbor, Mount Sinai Sailing Association, end of the season. Here we are at the Rube Goldberg Protecto bag for our now working autopilot. Is having some problems. Had to rewire a few things. Nothing we can't handle here on Akula. The walrus. I am the walrus. Cuckoo, ca-choo. I'm going to hit this number 6 too. So I'm going to put you down so I can pay attention. That's all, folks.